gift box with a lid.
The Christmas tree reappears.
Elf finger slippers.
Eight-pointed star picture frame, and the picture frame spins.
Hey everyone, Merry Christmas. In this video, I'm gonna show you five super easy and awesome origami Christmas models. Number one is the flying candy cane, and this is how it flies. And here's how to fold it. So for this flying candy cane and all of the models in this tutorial, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of origami paper. You could use ordinary printer paper cut square, but then you won't have the stripes on the candy cane. So I recommend using paper that's colored on one side and white on the other. So let's begin white side up, and let's fold diagonally in half, but not all the way. We want to leave a little white stripe here and here. So it's about like that. Now, let's turn over and let's fold the bottom edge up a little bit. How far? About like this. What you want is for these two edges to be equal in length. And crease sharply. And now fold the edge up again. So we're just rolling it up. And fold it up again. And we're rolling it all the way up, folding each time, and try to keep it even. Like that. And now let's rotate 180 degrees and hold here and here, and you're ready to fly it.
Okay, so to fly it, you just hold it horizontal and separate the two corners about that much, and then let go of both of them at the same time. Like that. And once you fly it the first time, you should be able to just throw it up and it'll spin. Isn't that cool? Now for number two. Number two is a super simple gift box with a lid, and I'll show you how to make the lid a little bit bigger than the box so it fits on perfectly. And this is how to fold it.
All right, so for this gift box, we need two squares, one for the box and one for the lid. So let's start out with the box. So let's begin white side up and let's fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. And now let's unfold and let's fold the bottom edge to the crease. Fold exact. And rotate. And now let's fold this edge to here. And now let's fold this edge up about this much. And rotate, and let's fold this edge up the same amount. Okay, before we go any further, let's do the same thing with the red sheet, with the lid. So let's begin the same way. Let's fold in half and unfold. And now let's fold this edge almost to the crease, but not quite. You want to leave about 1 or 2 millimeters. So it's like that. And rotate. And let's repeat on this side. So I just left about 1.5 millimeters. And now let's fold the flap up the same amount that you folded it up here. This will just make the lid a tiny bit wider so that it'll fit nicely over the box. And let's rotate and let's do the same thing on this side. Okay, now let's continue with the box. So let's unfold these two flaps and let's fold this corner up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And let's repeat on this side. And let's fold this flap down. And let's rotate, and let's repeat on this side. And fold the flap down. Okay, now we just need to open the box up. So open it like this, and now we just have to shape the box. So let's first make the fold that goes between these two points. So just pinch it like that. And let's fold right on this edge. And same thing over here. So there's one side of the box. And now let's just repeat on this side. Alright, there's the gift box, and now we just need to repeat for the lid. And here's the box, and the lid. And let's see if they fit well together. They do. And there it is. The present box, ready to fill with a gift. Ta-da.
Number three is the magical Christmas tree. When you turn it over, the Christmas tree disappears. But when you shine light on it from behind, the Christmas tree reappears. And this is how to fold it.
All right, so for this Christmas tree, I'm going to use a sheet of green origami paper. And this is just six folds. So let's begin colored side up. And let's pretend like we're making a paper airplane, but we're actually just going to fold the flaps up about that much. This stripe here is going to be the trunk of the tree. Just try to keep it as even as possible. So those are the first two folds. And now let's rotate. And let's actually make the middle fold just to make it a little bit more even. So we're going to fold it in half, but just crease mark right here, like that, and unfold. And now let's fold this corner to the end of the crease mark. So about like that. And rotate. And let's fold this corner to here. And rotate. And let's fold this flap up to taste, just to shorten the trunk. So if you want a longer trunk, you'll fold like that. If you want it shorter, you'll fold like this. So here we have a tree with an upside down flying saucer on the tip of it. Let's rotate and let's fold the flying saucer so that it disappears. It vanishes. And rotate. And there we have the tree. And when you turn it over, the tree disappears, but when you shine a light on it, the tree reappears. And there you have it. Now you can fold a whole bunch of them and you can make a forest. And you can draw on them to decorate your tree. There it is.
Number four is this really cute elf slipper. And you can even put it on your finger. So you end up with elf finger slippers. And here's how to fold them.
Alright, so for this elf shoe, you could use any size square of paper. In fact, if you use a big enough square, you might even be able to wear it. But I'm going to use an ordinary 6-inch square of origami paper. Let's begin white side up, and let's fold diagonally in half. Try to make precise folds and piece sharply. And now let's rotate and let's fold this edge onto the long edge. And now let's rotate and let's fold this flap over this edge. And let's rotate and let's unfold these two flaps. We can leave this one folded and open the pocket and let's stick these two flaps into the pocket and flatten. And let's rotate. And now let's fold this short edge onto the longest edge. Not onto this edge, but onto the longest edge. And rotate. And now let's fold this flap over. How far? Well, if we fold it really far, it'll be a short shoe. If we fold it less, it'll be a larger shoe. I'm going to fold it so that it's a shorter shoe. That way it'll fit my finger. Okay, let's stick this flap into this pocket. Like that. And now we just need to stick our finger into the shoe, like that. And now let's squash here. And there we have the elf shoe or elf slipper. And we can curl it up like that. And if you want, you can shape it more by putting your finger in here and just squashing the heel. Like that, just pinch it. And now just shape the slipper to taste. And this could either be a high, well, not a very high heel, or you can just flatten it down like that. And there is the elf shoe. And if you make another one, then you can have a pair of elf shoes and you can stick them on your fingers and do a little dance. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Or if you curl them a little bit more, they can hook onto each other. I'll save you! So there's the elf shoes.
And lastly, number 5 is the super simple 8-pointed star. And when you fold the corners behind, it turns into a golden octagon. No, but check it out. When you turn it over, it's a red 8-pointed star. And when you open the flaps, it can be used as a picture frame. And here's how to fold it.
All right, so for this 8-pointed star picture frame, I'm going to use a yellow 6-inch square of origami paper. And just so that you can see it a little bit better, I'm going to use a sheet of green printer paper as my background. So let's start with white side up and let's fold in half. And unfold and rotate and let's fold in half again. And unfold. And now let's fold all four corners to the middle. Now let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with the top here. But we're not going to make the whole fold. We just need to flatten right here. So we make a pinch mark there and unfold. And now let's fold the flap up again so that this edge aligns with this edge. And once again, we're not going to flatten the whole thing. Just flatten right there. And unfold. And now let's fold this flap up so that these two crease marks touch this edge. So it's like that. And let's rotate and let's repeat with this flap. So fold this edge to here and just flatten right here and unfold and fold the flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge and flatten right here and unfold and fold the flap up so that the two crease marks align with this edge. Like that. And let's rotate and let's repeat with these two flaps, but we don't need to make the pinch marks. Just fold it up so that this edge aligns with this edge and this edge aligns with this edge. Like that. And rotate and let's repeat with the last flap. There we have it. And let's turn over. So here we have the eight-pointed star, but it doesn't look very good because it looks more like a square on top of a square. So we're going to turn back over and let's fold all of these eight corners in, starting with this one. And now let's fold this flap up. Make sure that the fold aligns with this edge behind it. And continue all the way around. All right, so here we have the white eight-pointed star, and we can unfold all of these eight flaps and turn over. And now you see the star looks just a little bit better because the creased flaps look kind of like the edges. So it looks more symmetrical, like a star. And now let's turn back over. And if you want, you can stick a picture into the frame. I'm gonna stick this emoji dude that I cut out from a junk mail catalog. So put it on like this and just lift one flap up and stick it inside and lift this flap up, stick it inside and this flap and here and center it. And there is the picture frame. And if you want, you can fold the corners in again. And now the emoji dude is framed by an eight-pointed star. And if you fold it in half, like this, and unfold, and fold it perpendicular in half, like this, and unfold, then the emoji dude, or whatever picture you have in the frame, will spin. Isn't that cool? And there you have it.
So there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you liked it, then click the thumbs up button. And if you want to be notified when I come out with new videos, then subscribe. And to my subscribers all over the world, I wish you a very Merry Christmas. Bye bye.